Hello students, I'm Dr. Akanksha Srivastav and I'm Associate Professor in Department of Business Administration at Lal Bahadur Shastri Group of Institutions, Lucknow. In today's class, I will discuss a new act, that is the Maternity Benefit Act 1961. It is a part of Unit 5 of the subject Employee Relations and Labour Laws, and it is there in MBA third semester as HR specialization. So let's start with the act. What I will discuss in today's class, that is introduction of Maternity Benefit Act. Then there are certain features of Maternity Benefit Act 1961. That I will discuss. Then where this act is applicable, applicability of the Maternity Benefit Act 1961, that I will discuss. Then payment of benefit, how the payment is made for the benefit under this act, that I will take on. And then entitlement of the benefit in different possibilities. There could be many possibilities in maternity benefit. So what are these different kind of possibilities that I will talk about, and in those possibilities where employee is fully entitled or when the employee is partially entitled, that I will discuss. Then there is a very important clause, that is notice of claim. What is notice of claim, when it should be given, that I will discuss. Then I will discuss features of MB Amendment Act 2017. This act came into force in 1961, right? But in 2017, there are major amendments under the Maternity Benefit Act. So, what are these major amendments, that I will discuss. Then who is entitled for maternity benefit in case of death of a woman, that I will discuss. And in last, the condition in which this benefit, the maternity benefit, can be forfeited, what is the condition for this, that I will discuss. So these are certain main provisions of the Maternity Benefit Act that I will take in today's class. So let's start with the class. Okay, so first of all, introduction. As the act title, the Maternity Benefit Act, the maternity benefit, it itself says this is specifically for the women employees, right? God has given certain distinct qualities to the women. She can give birth to a baby, right? And it is completely different experience for a woman, and it is a very challenging process also. So all the lawmakers, not only in India, all around the globe, lawmakers think that they should provide certain facilities to the women workers so that they can through with the process calmly. If we talk about India, we have this, the Maternity Benefit Act 1961, right? And the aim of the act is to make available all the necessary facilities to a working woman, and it makes an employer liable towards a pregnant woman worker so that she can avail all the needed facility. It is an employer's responsibility to take care of or to provide all the needed accommodation which are necessary for the health of a working woman and for her child. So this act ensures that a woman worker should calmly through with this process, because there are so many physical challenges as well as emotional challenges, right? So this act act basically ensures a working woman so that she can overcome this state easily. So this is the introduction. Okay, now there are certain features of the Maternity Benefit Act 1961. It prohibits the working woman to employment during definite period of her pregnancy and for 6 weeks immediately after the delivery of the child, right? You can understand it like there is a expected date of delivery, right? From this date, and for a certain period before this date, that is expected date of delivery. This is a duration for which act prohibits a working woman for the job or for the work. For this particular duration, a pregnant woman is not allowed to work, right? Second point is, or second feature is, maternity benefit in the form of leave with wages, right? There is a provision of leave with wages and for the maximum period of 12 weeks. This is the benefit which an employee, a working woman, is entitled or she can claim for the maternity benefit to her employer for a maximum 12 weeks of leave with wages, right? There are certain more provisions like provisions for leave with wages in case of, there are cases like miscarriage, if there is any mishappening with the baby. In that case, if miscarriage happened, then there is a provision for leave with wages. If any medical termination of pregnancy due to any complication is there, then there is a provision of leave with wages. And if any kind of tubectomy operation of the employed women, then also there are provision for leave with wages. So these are certain features of Maternity Benefit Act 1961. Okay, now the applicability. The Maternity Benefit Act applies in factories, right, mines, plantation, and every establishment employing person for the exhibition of equestrian, acrobatic and other performances, like where much physical work is required, it is applicable in those establishments, right? And one more condition is there, every shop and establishment where 10 or more persons are employed or were employed on any day of the preceding 12 month, in any establishment or in any shop, if the employer number reaches to 10 in any day of the 12 month period, then this act will be applicable there, right? After that, if this number falls to 9 or 8 or 7, it does not matter, because in labor laws, any act once applied is always applied. Okay, so this is the applicability of this act. Now, payment of maternity benefit. According to section 5 subsection 1, every woman is entitled for the payment of maternity benefit at the rate of average daily wage for the duration of her actual absence preceding the day of her delivery and for the 6 weeks immediately following that day, right? I have just told you there is a expected date of delivery, right? With this date immediately after the 6 weeks from this date and before this date, the actual day or date on which that female has applied for the leave, for this total duration she is liable for, she is eligible for the payment or for the leave with wages, right? So average daily wage for this duration she will receive as a maternity benefit. So this is the way how the payment is being made in maternity benefit. Now the qualifying period, which is the condition which makes a woman employee entitled for the maternity benefit, according to section 5 subsection 2, all the women who have worked in an establishment for 80 days in 12 months period, 80 days in 12 months period immediately preceding the expected delivery date can claim maternity benefit to her employer, right? At least a woman should work for 80 days in a 12 month period, only that woman is entitled for this benefit. It is not like any women has joined just 20 days before or 30 days before or 40 days before she can claim for maternity benefit. No, at least a woman need to work for 80 days in a 12 month period, only that woman can claim for the maternity benefit to her employer, and this conditions make her entitled for this benefit, right? So this is the qualifying period. Now, entitlement to maternity benefit in different possibility. As we know that carrying a baby and delivering the baby and after that, the whole procedure is very crucial. There could be any possibility. So what are these possibilities, right? And in which possibility a woman is fully entitled or a woman is partially entitled, that we will discuss in this with the help of this table. So first possibility could be a mother is alive, right? A child may be alive or not alive in case of if there is a still baby, right? So if mother is alive and if child is alive or not alive, in that case woman is fully entitled, she is fully entitled for the benefit, that is the 12 weeks paid leave, okay. Second case is if woman is not alive, right, and this case is further segregated into two conditions, if mother dies before the birth of the child, right, entitled up to and including the day of her death. Now in this case she is not getting the complete maternity benefit, she will only receive the benefit up to and including the day of her death. Second condition is if mother dies after the birth of the child, after the birth of the child, that means what, child is alive, mother is not alive but child is alive, in that case again she is fully entitled, right? And the another case is if mother is not alive as well as the child is not alive, right, in that case she is entitled up to and including the day of the death who dies in last or who dies later, right? So if mother is alive and child alive or a still baby, in both the cases she is fully entitled. In a case where mother is not alive, right, and there are two conditions, if she dies before the birth of the baby, then she is entitled up to and including the day of her death. But if baby is alive, if the mother dies after the birth of the child and the child is alive, in that case she is fully entitled. If mother is not alive as well as child is not alive, in that case she will be entitled up to including the day of the death, right? So these could be certain possibilities which are probable in the case or in the whole duration. So Act has entertained or has clauses for each and every separate possibility. I hope it is clear. Okay. Then it is very important, notice for claim. According to section 6, any woman who is entitled to maternity benefit may give notice in writing to her employer, right? In that notice, there are certain things which she need to mention. She need to provide certain kind of information, like number one, provide the detail of the nominee. Detail of the nominee, right? Like if something mishappened to the woman who is entitled for the benefit, then in that case who is going to receive the benefit amount, who will be the nominee, right? So she need to provide the information, provide the detail about the nominee. Then she need to state the date from which she will claim maternity benefit and payment thereof. She need to define about, or she need to give that specific date on which she will take the leave from the employment, right? So that employer can easily understand that how much benefit he for that amount he is actually liable to pay that woman employee, right? Then amount of benefit for the period preceding the date of expected delivery shall be paid in advance, right? The leave which a woman has taken before the expected date of delivery, for that duration the amount of benefit can be paid in advance, right? Then amount of benefit which is left shall be paid within 48 hours of production of proof that the woman has been delivered the child. The remaining amount after paying that advance, the remaining amount which is left, employer is liable to pay that amount within 48 hours as he receives the information about that the child has been delivered. This is the last point in notice of claim, but it is very important. It is failure to give notice shall not disentitle the woman to maternity benefit, right? It is there, a woman who is expecting shall provide a notice to her employer, but if she misses or she is not able or she failure to give the notice, this does not make her disentitled for the benefit. Even if she has not given any kind of notice to her employer, she still remain entitled for the, she will still remain entitled for the maternity benefit. Okay. Now there are certain features of the Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017. This act has been amended in 2017 and there are certain very important amendments under this act. Let's see what are these amendments. Duration of paid maternity leave increased from 12 weeks to 26 weeks. The paid leave which was there in the act in 1961, that was 12 weeks. It has been increased in 2007 and it has been increased to 26 weeks. But there is a condition for this. In case of a woman who has less than 2 surviving children, if a woman is expecting for the first time, she is eligible for 26 week paid leaves. If a woman is expecting for a second baby, that means she is already having one child, in that case also she is entitled for 26 weeks paid leave. But if a woman is expecting third time, she is already having 2 surviving kids or 2 surviving children, in that case, it is written here, in other cases, 12 weeks maternity leave shall continue, right? If any woman is already having 2 children, in that case she is eligible for 12 weeks maternity leave only or 12 weeks maternity benefit only, right? The second feature is all establishments where 50 or more employees are working, irrespective of gender, right? It is not like 50 working women should be there. If in any establishment there are 50 employees irrespective of their gender working, shall have a creche facility, right? An employer shall permit 4 visits a day including the interval for rest. If any woman whose child is there in the creche, then that woman shall be allowed for the 4 visits in a day including the interval or rest, right? This is the second feature. The third feature is, it is related to an adopting mother and a commissioning mother, right? In the Amendment Act of Maternity Benefit, they add this clause that is related to adopting mother and commissioning mother also. And what it says, an adopting mother who adopted a child below the age of 3 months, below the age of 3 months, and a commissioning mother. Commissioning mother is a biological mother, basically she uses her eggs for the embryo, but she doesn't carry in her own womb. The embryo is implanted in other women, right? So in both the cases, if any adopting mother who's adopted a child below the age of 3 months or any commissioning mother shall be entitled for 12 weeks maternity leave from the date the child is handed over, right? Is it clear? Now there are few more features which is there in the Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017, and these are, if the nature of work allowed the facility of work from home, the employer may allow the employed women even after the completion of the maternity benefit, and the period for work from home must be mutually decided by the employer and the women employee. Right? If the nature of work may so allowed, yes, there is a possibility that the women can work from home. So employer may allow her, allow that woman, yes, she can work from home after, even after the completion of the maternity benefit and for how long she will be allowed for the work from home, it should be mutually decided by the employer and that working woman employee, right? So work from home feature has been added in this amendment act. Then next feature is, it is employer's responsibility to make aware all the women employees about all the benefits available under the act in writing. It is totally employer's responsibility. It is totally employer's responsibility that he'll make aware all his women employees about the benefits which are available under the act, and it must be in writing. And the last feature is, women employee can avail paid maternity leave 8 weeks prior to the expected date of delivery. If you remember, before this amendment, it was 6 weeks prior to the expected date of delivery. Maximum a woman can take 6 weeks leave prior to her expected date of delivery. It has been increased up to 8 weeks, right? So these are certain amendments, certain features of the Maternity Benefit Amendment Act 2017. Now, who is entitled to maternity benefit in case of death of a woman? According to Section 7, if woman dies before receiving the benefit, employer shall pay the amount of the benefit to the nominee who is mentioned by the woman in the notice. We have already discussed about it. There is a notice of claim. In that, a woman is required, a woman who is entitled for the benefit, she is required to provide the detail about the nominee. Right. So, in case if entitled woman dies, in that case the nominee will receive the benefit. Okay. And if there is no nomination, if there is a condition of failure to provide the notice, in that case any legal heir whosoever is there will receive the maternity benefit. Right. Then four feature of maternity benefit. What is the condition in which the maternity benefit could be forfeited? Under Section 18, any woman if works for any period during such authorized absence, according to Section 6, shall forfeit her claim to maternity benefit. The duration for which acts prohibit the woman, she is not allowed for work, right? And if she works somewhere else, if she feels, no, I'm okay in this particular establishment, I have applied or I have claimed for the maternity benefit, so I'll find out some other establishment, I'll go there and I'll work and I will earn some money, right? That is completely wrong. That is not right. If that is the situation, the period, the duration for which she is not allowed for work, if she found working at in that duration, then this situation forfeit her claim to the maternity benefit. So these are certain important provision under this act. I have discussed Maternity Benefit Act 1961. I have discussed the crucial amendment which are there in Maternity Benefit Act Amendment Act 2017. With this, this act is over. In the next class, we'll discuss a new act. Thank you.